Good evening, and welcome to this December 19th edition of Off the Map Live. I am your host, Ben Licata. Welcome. Thanks to our audio podcast listeners, because I know this is new to you. Hope you're enjoying it. My guests tonight are Max Rothert and Mark Tousignant. What's that, Tim? Tousignant. Is that French-Canadian?
Yes, it is.
I think he's actually Canadian. I think that's... Are you French?
Nope, just Canadian.
Just Canadian. Are your boys Canadian?
Nope.
Oh, you poor suckers. Sorry, guys. Your life could have been better. Show is brought to you by Paradise Tattoo Gathering webinars that we have just put together. Hey, Tim, are those webinars live?
The Off the Map webinars?
The Paradise Tattoo Gathering webinars?
No.
Oh. As soon as we get approval from our teachers of those seminars, they will be available to you at tattoonow.com/webinars. If you couldn't make it out to the Paradise Tattoo Gathering, you stink, because it was a good time. But if you wanted to learn from those people, those webinars will be available soon. Wow, it's so quiet in here tonight. No one's making any noise. Hey, Gabe, what are you listening to over there? Can't even hear me. Kelsey, what are you doing over there? Are you doing the news tonight?
Yeah.
You are? Sweet. So we'll have the news back for you with Josh Sahoza and Kelsey Moll. Brr, it's chilly out there. Hi, Billy.
Hey, Ben.
How's everything outside?
Very cold.
It's chilly?
Chilly.
Chilly, really.
We're also brought to you by Reinventing the Tattoo, now available in ebook form, sort of, electronic app form. The printed book is not available anymore. You talk to any tattooer out there who's worth his salt, he knows that reinventing, or she knows that reinventing the tattoo is an indispensable tool to make you a better tattooer. Mark, have you read it?
Yep.
Once or twice?
At least.
Josh?
I had a bootleg copy 11 years ago.
Josh stole a copy because he's a punk rocker. He's a punk rocker. Josh, a hoser, is a punk rocker. We're also brought to you by Dax McClellan and his realistic portrait system. At tattooingportraits.com, Dax has been a generous supporter of the show all season. Hopefully we'll get him back next season. He's the one who brings you this fancy set we have here. Right? No? Nodding doesn't get heard on the microphone.
Hell yeah.
That's better. I also brought to you by Voluta Digital and their Tattoo Release Form app, which is available to you now. Version 2.0 just came out. It's pretty... It's pretty great. We haven't killed any trees doing our release forms in over a year. Josh gives it a thumbs up. It's easy to use. Most of your clients already know how to use mobile stuff anyway. You hand them an iPad, they fill out all their information, it goes to the cloud. You don't have to fill out any paper anymore. You don't have to store a bunch of file cabinets worth of release forms in your storage. You can use it for other stuff. And as always, brought to you by Off the Map Tattoo, where we are broadcasting to you from right now. At our new location in Easthampton, Massachusetts, at the old Majestic Theater. I know the set's not very majestic. I wish I could show you the whole thing. Hey, Tim, for the next show, can we do like a wide shot of the whole place? Like maybe a still shot?
Yes.
Show people some of the cool stuff in here? So, for those of you guys who have been paying attention, you know that Tim St. John has been our producer for most of this season. Most? Half? Half the season?
Yeah, a little more than half.
So that's been pretty good. I've been able to take a little break from all of that stuff and tattoo a little bit more. This will be our last live show of the season. Our next episode will be a best of show. Stay tuned, because I'm sure Tim will put together a whole bunch of embarrassing clips of me and everybody else doing stupid shit on the show like we do all the time. And some of the key highlights of what we brought to you this season. If you're watching on Facebook, cool. Check it out on iTunes as well and go give us a review or a rating. We could use them. We're also available on YouTube, where you can find almost 4 years of archived interviews. I've interviewed dozens of people on there. If there's someone that you want to see on the show, send us a message through any of those outlets, and we'll try to get them on the show. Like I said, this episode is Max Rothert and Mark.
Tousignant.
No, I was waiting for Mark to say it.
Tousignant.
Tousignant. The Canadian wonder. So we'll see you in just a few minutes after these messages. We'll be back with Mark, and then we'll bring Max up after that. So we'll see you in just a bit. Thanks for watching.
At whatever stage you may be in your tattoo career, apprentice,
experienced street shop tattooer or fully custom artist, it's hard not to feel a little competitive in today's tattoo industry, with so many amazing artists working in all styles in virtually every corner of the world. But you can benefit right now by learning from the experience of the tattoo professionals who have dedicated themselves to education in this industry. I'm Guy Aitchison, and I've been teaching in the tattoo field for much of my 27 years in the trade, with most of my educational efforts being focused within my Reinventing the Tattoo platform, which has been an industry standard in education for nearly two decades. Reinventing was originally conceived as a series of seminars that I held at tattoo conventions, and its curriculum has been filled out and fine-tuned according to the needs of the artists attending these classes. It's now a massive standalone educational package which can be viewed on any kind of device in order to bring the answers you need right to your fingertips. The Reinventing the Tattoo curriculum is centered around a group of fundamental artistic principles of composition, including flow and fit on the body, contrast, positive-negative relationships, color theory, depth, and other concepts, which are framed in a way that is meant to be as useful as possible to working tattoo artists. The material then covers uses of reference imagery and digital tools in your design process, along with a review of alternate art forms such as oils and watercolors and how they can help refine your skills as a tattoo artist. The technical sections are as comprehensive as possible, covering everything from machines and other basic equipment to stenciling and working on various challenging parts of the body. Not only am I sharing everything useful that I know about these subjects, but I'm also enlisting the help of various top-name professionals, such as Russ Abbott, Nick Baxter, Megan Jean Morris, Phil Garcia, Halo Jankowski, and Don McDonald to share their own experience on these topics. You may have already read the book version of Reinventing the Tattoo. However, the new electronic edition has been seriously updated and expanded beyond the scope of the old book, including not only new chapters by myself and our guest writers, but also introducing a massive section on cover-up tattooing, including chapters on lasers and scar cover-ups, plus loads of new video footage to further illustrate the book's topics. Subscribers can look forward to seeing new material added regularly along with further updates to existing content as the Reinventing curriculum continues to expand and evolve. I'd like to invite you to drop by reinventingthetattoo.com to read more about what we have to offer in the Reinventing the Tattoo educational package. It's the biggest and most detailed teaching effort I've ever been involved with, and I'm completely confident that no matter where you stand in your tattoo career, it can help you to take your work to the next level.
Tried. Hey, we're back with Mark. Hey, Mark.
Hey.
How are you, man?
How you doing?
Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
I'm glad you could be here.
Yeah, me too.
So Mark's kids are in the audience, so we're going to keep it clean. Right, boys?
Hello.
So Mark, for those who don't know, tell me a little bit about your history. How did you find tattooing?
I've always been kind of attracted to it, a little outside the box kind of person my whole life. So being the outcast has always been very attractive to me, you know. And I've never really been one to stand with other people. I've always stood on my own. And so that outlaw-ish art, going against the social norms, was always kind of intriguing to me and very attractive. And then so one day in like 98 or 99, I met this guy, Junior. And I got my graffiti crew tattooed on my leg. And he was like, oh, I want to paint graffiti. And I was like, oh, I want a tattoo. And he was like, all right, let's be friends. And he taught me to tattoo, and he taught me even more about painting because I didn't really know much. And we've been friends ever since. Still talk all the time. He's out in Vegas now.
Was that your first tattoo?
No.
All right, so tell me a little bit about the story of your first tattoo.
My first tattoo was my punk rocker tattoo. It's in the center of my back. It's four initials, ACAB. I'm sure everybody knows what that means.
If you don't know what that means,
Google it.
Look it up.
And and that was in some little tiny shop up in Kingston, Ontario. And I traded some flash sheets for it. That was my first introduction into tattooing. And from there on, I was hooked.
So do you have an art background? Like a formal art background?
Nope.
No,
all self-taught.
Were you always an artistic kid?
Yes.
I've noticed a lot lately that you've been drawing stuff directly on people.
Yep.
Is that a newer thing for you, or have you been doing that for a long time?
I've been doing it for a long time. I just feel in this environment that it pushes growth so much that I feel like I should push myself to as hard as I can. And I find that even though, like, I'll still do my homework in a sketchbook the night before, and then I'll come in with a reference sketch and I'll draw it right on the skin. Like I said, so that it fits better, so
sure.
That the movement's better.
What's up?
We were going with a feedback loop that whole time.
Okay. How about now?
We're not now.
Okay. We'll just keep going.
Okay.
It's all right.
Just
letting you know. It's all right. Sorry for the technical difficulties, folks. So speaking about this environment and then what you said earlier about being an outlaw, this is very much kind of a, I don't know, it's almost a family here. Has it been hard for you to adjust?
No. This has been the easiest transition into a new shop that I've ever had, ever. I've never met a group of people that were so open and welcoming and just immediately took me right in as part of the family as if I had been here for years.
And
made me feel right at home.
How long have you been here?
6 months and 2 weeks.
Not that he's
counting. I started June 1st, and so yeah, you know, 6.5 months or whatever.
So how does this shop differ than from some of the other shops you've been at?
There's no internal competition here at all. There's no, I'm better than this person, or this person's not as good as that person. There's none of that here. And it's very encouraging, so it allows everybody to grow at their own pace, and you know, having a great support staff and good management that is dedicated to helping us achieve our goals is incredible because it allows us to do wonderful things. You know, when we decide that we want to do something or we want to hit a certain mark, you know, we all know that we have the people behind us to get us there, which is pretty freaking cool.
Yeah, it's not bad, huh?
You know, I worked in a lot of other shops where there was a lot of competition, a lot of like, why does he get to do this and I can't do that? And why is he doing better than me? And it was never about like, wow, he's doing something great. I want to learn how to do what he's doing. It was always just putting people down, and I'm over that. You know, I don't want to be around it. And that's what's not here.
Not at all. Was it hard to keep going in shops that were in like that kind of environment? Because, I mean, you've been tattooing for, what, 11, 12 years?
Yeah. Well, I did take a little bit of a break, which I'm not going to go into today. But, yeah, I learned in the 90s, and like I said, it was very street shop oriented. It was licking sticks. You'd pick a number off the wall, basically. And then the tattoo industry started to, you know, go more out into custom, and I tried to follow that route. And I can't remember where I was going with that.
I was just wondering how the shops you've worked at before, like, was it hard to stay there?
Yeah,
you know, well, with that dynamic.
There was a lot of backstabbing, and in those days, there wasn't a lot of upstanding people that ended up in the industry for some reason. There's always the few gems. Like, don't get me wrong. I met some incredible people over the years, but there was a lot of two-faced, a lot of backstabbing, a lot of stealing, a lot of, like, client poaching, and not in the way of, I'm going to help this client get the best possible tattoo, but being a lot of people that were motivated strictly by the dollar.
Sure.
And
I mean, I see it every week. People here are like, maybe this tattoo won't work for me, but I know this guy.
Yeah.
You know, like Josh will say, like, this isn't really my thing. Maybe Mark should handle this one. You know, that's
right. And that's the best. That's the best all around. It's the best piece for the artist. It's the best piece for the client. And you know, making sure that the client gets the best possible piece is always the most important thing to me.
So how do you stay motivated with art these days? What inspires you?
Geez, if I just look around the room, you know, every day when I'm here. I remember when I did my first guest spot here and I sat down in the guest artist booth and I looked up and I saw a Jeff Gogway original. And I was like, holy crap. It was it wasn't intimidating, though. It was like, wow, you know, like I'm sitting right next to this amazing piece of art, and then I turn my head and then there's pictures from Marcus Leonard, and there's, you know, we got Guy Aitchison originals on the wall over here, and we got Adam France in the gallery. And I mean, it's not hard to stay motivated.
Sure.
When you're looking around, everywhere I look, I'm looking at people that I've looked up to for years, you know, their work, and not just their tattoos, but like their fine art and, you know, a lot of other stuff. It's incredible. You know, you got guys like Gabe that just sit and paint all day and do oil paintings that blow my mind. Like,
he's been sitting there painting for like 11 hours.
Yeah. He's a madman.
Yeah. What?
He's not painting.
He's just
unemployed. Oh, he's just texting Leanne all day. I really love you. I hope you make me some quesadillas. Keep the green chilies out of it. He's got his earphones in. He can't understand what I'm saying. I remember when you first came around, you were coming to our drawing nights and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I was impressed with the motivation that you kept showing up. Because we have our drawing nights in a bar.
Yeah.
And you have nothing to do with bars.
Yeah. I don't drink.
And I was impressed by that. I was like, wow, this guy, he gives a shit. A bunch of, you know, that was like the rejects of the shop would go out and draw outside of the shop and, you know, have 3 or 4 beers and you would show up and draw. And I was really impressed with your motivation.
I just want to be around other motivated artists. And the fact that you guys were taking time outside of the workday, you know, you're there together as a group, together, being the big thing, and everybody producing art, everybody being productive, You know, clearly everybody's motivated. So what if you're having a couple of beers recreationally? You're
sure.
Still, you know, you're still making steps in the direction that I want to follow in. You know, and if we all walk that same direction together, that path becomes much easier to travel.
So do you do anything outside of work to continue, like, art education or anything like that? Have you taken any courses? Or?
No, not right now. My schedule is very tight. With my wife being an internship in her last year of her doctorate, ties up a lot of my free time. So pretty much every minute I have right now is spent with those two guys sitting right there.
Could be worse. Those guys look pretty awesome.
No, it's rad. I love it. I'm having a ball.
Do you ever have a chance to take seminars or anything like that during your travels? Have you or online at all? Have you ever seen any of those?
Yeah, I definitely take a lot of seminars. More so now that I'm here, obviously.
Uh-huh.
Paradise took a bunch. It's got to sit on a few. And before then, I would try to catch seminars at any show I would go to, and usually it was just not worth the money in a lot of the shows. A lot of those guys that are on the road doing seminars, like, don't take this the wrong way, but there's a lot of guys out there that are just snaking your money.
Yeah, I've seen it.
And probably the best thing for continuing my education was actually when I went out to hyperspace to see Guy.
Yeah, I was going to mention that. You recently just got your chest done by Guy.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little bit about that experience?
Oh, geez, I don't even know where to start. It was truly a life-changing experience. It changed things on a lot of levels, on fundamental levels, like in how I treat my client, how I help them with pain management, I think was probably the biggest thing I took away from that. Guy got me to do things and go through things that I never thought was possible, and in many ways, not just in the physical pain level, but also in having the mental strength to sit through it. We did 2 8-hours of 2 days, 8 hours each of tattooing, and each day spanned approximately 16 hours of actually being at hyperspace.
Damn.
They were very long days. They would go from noon till 3 in the morning,
mm-hmm.
both days, and I would sleep 2 to 3 hours, and then I would be driving back out to hyperspace for the next day. And I would do it, again, at the drop of a hat, and there
would
be
no questions. Well, I'm sure you're going to get that chance again, too, because you're going to keep going with that project,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
It was great. It was so surreal being out there. You're so disconnected. You're, like, 20 miles outside of the nearest city, and the nearest city is barely a city.
It's
tiny.
Carbondale. It's tiny. Yeah, there's like a breakfast joint, coffee shop, small college, and that's about it.
Yeah, but it was nice. I mean, it's like being in a little bubble, having those few days of disconnect and the isolation was super cool.
I know you've drawn some bio in the past. Did that experience kind of rekindle any of that?
Yeah, I have such a love for bio. It is like my secret little dirty little secret, you know. I love to draw it. The stuff that I have painted that's at my house is all bio. I'm not proud of it. I don't love it. Like I said, it's my dirty little secret. Someday I may pursue it a little further. Right now I just kind of roll with what the client dictates. You know, I'm having a lot of fun with what I'm doing, so I don't really feel the need to necessarily take on another style, especially one that I love that much and I feel deserves 100% devotion.
So there's
a lot of stuff that I apply from bio into my new school tattooing.
Sure. How do you attract the clientele that you're looking for? How do you get those people to come in and make appointments and sit down in your chair?
I don't know. Honestly, a lot of what I do is just having a lot of confidence in what I can deliver. I feel very confident in what I sell. If I tell you I can deliver it, I feel like I can deliver it. And I feel like my confidence rubs off onto my clients. You know, I'm confident about what I want to do, and they see that, and they pick up on it. I have work to back it up.
Right.
So most people let me put my own spin on things, which is it's pretty nice.
So you're a graffiti artist, and you're also a DJ. How do those things tie in with tattooing, and do they have similarities?
I don't know how DJing really ties in. I mean, I guess music does, just in general.
Do you find there's like a common sense of expression in being a DJ and being able to come up with original artwork? Is there a similar vein in that?
Yeah, both of them, as far as DJ, everybody's, you're trying to tell a story. Same thing you're trying to do with the tattoo. At least when you're doing larger scale stuff, you know, you want to have, you know, some sort of element to it. It's got to be going somewhere. It's got to be doing something. It can't just be a sticker, you know? So, yeah, DJing and art are pretty similar like that. The graffiti side of it, I mean, it's kind of obvious. You know, a lot of elements there, color theory, placement, movement, flow.
Well, I mean, it's obvious to me. It might not be obvious to the people that I'm talking to.
Fair enough.
It's an interview.
Fair
man.
Enough. yeah, and oddly enough, I hate doing letters. Absolutely hate it.
Unless it's on a cement wall somewhere? Or
even when that, like...
When when you are doing graffiti work, are you doing lettering? Are you doing
more character stuff?
Character stuff?
Yeah.
Do you ever get a chance to do that anymore?
No, it's been a long time. Local crew out here, ARE, my buddy Nate, he's invited me to go out a few times with them, and it's just so hard to get our schedules to line up right.
Well, I'm full-time tattooer, dad, husband, you know, I can understand not having
I mean, I wish I had more time, too. I would love to. I get the invite to go, but just making that time.
So I know you're not traveling a whole bunch in the coming year, but you are going to do a couple of local shows, probably.
Yeah. I'll be doing. I should be doing Sturbridge. It's still a little bit up in the air right now. That's in March, and then I'll be doing Tommy's in October again.
And Tommy's has been supporting you for a long time, right?
They've been years and years.
They're your boys, right?
Yep. Very good friends at Tommy's Supply.
Those guys are great. If you're local and you need to get something, they usually have it. They're great. They're super friendly to me. And last time I was down there, they were great.
I love those guys, man. I would do anything for them. They've always been there for me. You know, anytime I've ever needed anything, even before I was, closely affiliated with them.
So if someone's looking to get work from you, how's the best way that they can check out what you've done and get in touch with you?
They could go to marktousignant.com, marktousignant.com, and at the bottom of the page is contact form. There's little buttons to click and put in any pictures you want, and it's super easy. So, yeah, hit me up there.
And he's also on offthemaptattoo.com if you don't remember how to spell his last name, because I fuck up shit all the time, and I know that I might not spell it correctly.
Yeah, it's a tricky one. I've been rolling with that one my whole life. I don't think it's going anywhere either.
No, man, I wouldn't get rid of it. Don't trade it in for any silly tattoo or name or anything like that.
No, no gimmicks.
But, hey, thank you for joining me.
Thanks for having me.
It's been fun.
It's a good time.
I've enjoyed it. So everyone, Mark Tousignant, check him out. He's here, resident here. He's been here for a while now. Hopefully he'll be here for a long time.
I hope so.
I haven't seen any reason why that you wouldn't be. Not that I'm in charge of any of that shit anyway. We'll be back with Max Rothert in just a few minutes. If I can find him, he's probably drinking fancy wine and eating some expensive bread somewhere. We'll be back in just
some
a few minutes.
Cured meat.
What is a webinar? It's your chance to up your game and improve yourself with new techniques in art, in business, and tattooing. Webinars are streaming professional development seminars taught by the masters of their craft that you can watch in the comfort of your home, your studio, or even on the go on your mobile device. If you have a stable internet connection, you can stream a webinar. Here at Tattoo Now, we continually produce high-quality video presentations from top artists and business people. Our catalog includes hours of education from greats like Guy Aitchison, Bob Tyrell, EJ Betts, Jeff Gogway, Russ Abbott, James Kern, Tommy Helm, Ian McCowan, Kelly Doty, Remmer Oriana, and more all the time. These professional artists share their years of experience to accelerate your path and help you become more successful. Fill up on high-octane brain fuel now with the Tattoo Now webinar. Do you want to bring your career to the next level? Then webinars from Tattoo Now can help you do that.
So I'm Dax McClellan. I'm the creator of TattooingPortraits.com, and I'm the author of The Savage Way. Really, though, I just want to help tattoo artists overcome and learn how to do black and gray realism in portraits. I'm hosting a live one-hour webinar, but it's this Wednesday, okay? And it's only for the first 100 people that register below. All you got to do is click the link, fill it out, and I'll see you this Wednesday if you want to learn how to tattoo black and gray portraits without ruining your client's skin. I've been there. I had to learn how to do portraits on my own. I didn't have an apprenticeship. I've screwed up clients. I've screwed up my own confidence, and I know how not to do that. I know what works. I know the systems. And in this webinar, I'm going to go through all the things I know. I'm going to share my personal step-by-step portrait system. I'm going to share how to improve the shades and transitions between your tones, and how to understand gray wash. Also, how to shade smoother. I'm gonna throw all that in there, and I'm gonna do a live Q&A at the end of the webinar. But it's only for the first 100 people that sign up and show up live this Wednesday, okay? Fill it out right now. I'm gonna give you the opportunity to get my book at a discounted rate. You get a discount, and I'm gonna throw in $97 worth of bonuses when you enter right now. Now, this is only for the first 100 people. It might not be available tomorrow. Register for a webinar, get the book. I'll see you this Wednesday.
Hey, we're back. I don't know if my microphone is on. Hold on, let me check. Hey,
is mine on?
It is, it totally is.
Mine on?
Max is definitely on, because I've turned it on. We're here with Max Rothert. Hey, Max.
How's it going, Ben?
It's going okay. I feel like you were just here not too long ago.
I was.
It was like kamikaze.
Yeah,
kamikaze. At the end of the show.
Tried to sit down awkwardly, and then
that didn't work out.
You started asking me questions.
This is better, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So for those of you guys who don't know, Max has dual citizenship here and in Nazi Germany. I mean, Germany.
Yeah, yeah, in Germany.
It's been 70 years, I think. Sorry.
It's been 70 years, but it's coming around again.
That's here now.
Yeah, no, it's
no,
here
they're
now.
They're okay over there. They're okay over there.
Give it 4 years.
They're fine over there.
They don't like immigrants now.
Where? Germany?
Germany. Mm-hmm.
Fuck.
Yep.
So, Max.
So, 4 years prior is where we were.
So, Max is a resident here. He's one of the longest residents. I was going to say one of the oldest, but that's not true.
Nope.
He's a youngster.
Mm-hmm.
Next to Tim Senecal, you're number two.
Yep. He's got me by like 6 or 8 months. Probably, I think.
So what's kept you here all these years?
Everything that Mark said.
No. No. It's because he's afraid. He's afraid.
No.
Just kidding.
No, it's been really great to see Off the Map grow. Like, when I got here, there were 6 people, and there were 4, and we were at a small location. I mean, it was a destination location.
Which always shocked me. When I went to get tattooed at Off the Map, before I knew what the space was, I was getting tattooed by Sean Barber.
Mm-hmm.
And I walked into Off the Map and was like, what?
This is it?
This is this place? Yeah. This is the place I've been reading about? This, really?
Yeah. I mean, it was a huge step up from where I started.
So where'd you start?
I've said this like 3 or 4 times on this show.
I know, but I have to remind people. You
I
can
started
be brief about
at
it.
Route 66 Inc. in Portland, Connecticut. It's
Don't worry,
no
we
more.
Got plenty of time. We'll talk about the new stuff.
Yeah, it's no more. I think
doesn't exist anymore.
Like I saw like one of those little flyers that said like condemned or like scheduled for demolition.
Nice.
This was the other day. Like, the barbershop next door was, like, closed. And she's been there for God knows how long. And
we should go set up a little booth in front of the old shop. $50 tattoos.
Yeah, I was there when we painted the thing yellow. So.
So how did you make the transition from doing, like, White Sox baseballs to clock parts and Spartan helmets?
I have no idea. I started to just geek out, like,
what drove
little
you
things.
There? What inspired you to start concentrating on stuff like that?
I didn't.
What?
It just happened. Like, I did one tattoo, one or two tattoos, and then it was just like the snowball effect.
Mm-hmm.
And then I figured out a way of doing it that cut the time down, like, exponentially.
So, recently, within the last year or two, you've done a ton of, like, armor, clock parts, hourglasses, helmets, and I think you've kind of mastered that stuff. Mm. And we've talked about it. So you're going to try to branch out and do some more original composition kind of things?
Yes.
Where do you want to bring your work?
Yeah, well, I just totally purged my computer. Like, I had desktop reference from when you go down the rabbit hole.
Oh, yeah, man, like, I've seen your computer. It's a nightmare.
Yeah.
Or it was.
So it gets to nightmare stage, mm-hmm. and then I'm like, fuck this, and I take everything and put it into a folder.
Mm-hmm.
And I do that over and over and over again, and then I take that and put that into a folder. And so then I went through my computer and opened it up and went through thousands of photos for the past, like, week. Like,
I was, got rid of them?
Yeah. No.
Yes, get rid of them.
No. So I took the cool photos, and I have another thing where it's like my reference folder, and I've got like different things like flora, fauna, like animals, insects. And I just start putting
clocks.
Them. Yeah. I'm like, well, it's not clocks, it's clock mechanics. because I don't.
I know, you're not doing like old Timex like desk clocks.
Yeah.
I understand.
So I take all that and I put it in this place. So now, you know that game where you take like three or four like words and you put them together? And you draw that?
Yes.
Yeah. You've played that game.
I have. Yeah. I've actually played it with Mark. We did it at one of our earlier drawing nights at the Brass Cat.
Yeah. So it's like that game, but if I now have
but
a visual thing.
Sure.
Yeah, so like I'll open up a folder and be like, that photo's cool. And then I'll open up another one, that photo's cool. So last night I was like up until 5, like just putting shit together. And it's been great. Like the past like 24 hours have been like opening up images and playing around.
So in the last 2 years, you've probably slept, what, 7 hours? 10 hours?
It ebbs and flows.
Is it hard to maintain that kind of intensity?
Yeah. Finding your burnout point is really, really, really helpful. Like, recognizing when you're going to, like, you work really hard, and you keep working, and then all of a sudden, like, you start to feel tired.
Right.
And you start to not really give a shit. I mean, it's fucking terrible to say because you're a tattooer. And
sure.
It's, like, you should give a shit.
Every time.
But every fucking time. But you start not caring. And there's that little slip. And then that slips again. And that slips again. But recognizing the first slip is like, all right, I need to step back and I need to realize that what I'm doing, like what other part of what I'm doing in life is making me slip. So, like if you're not getting enough sleep,
I'm just kidding.
if you're not getting enough sleep, well then take some time and get a little bit more sleep.
Sure.
If, like, your outside life is affecting your, like, work. I mean, it's life. Like, it's all one.
What I've noticed
Josh
about
told me that the other
the
day.
Tattoo
like,
world, there
one.
Is no work life, personal life. As a tattooer, it's just your life.
It is.
And a lot of people that have watched television shows don't understand that at all. It's not a career. It is a life.
Yeah.
And every tattooer that I've talked
to... It's not a lifestyle either.
No, every tattooer that I've talked to that's been doing it for 10 years or more has been like, no, it's not a job.
Yeah.
It's your life.
Yeah.
All
the sooner you realize that, and the sooner you can like actually take that and make it a holistic life, like put it all into one and like recognize different parts of what your life is.
It's super hard to find other people that want to play that game with you.
Yeah.
That aren't involved in this stuff.
Man.
And I'm not going to go any deeper than that, but it's taken a little bit. My wife has taken a lot of time to try to get used to that kind of stuff because it's hard to drag someone along with you into that life.
Yeah,
it's
especially
not,
like...
Because you come home and it's not like work's over. You're just home, you know?
You're just home and work kind of continues.
It just keeps going until you get up in the morning and then you do a little bit more
and
work
you're
because you're awake.
It's the difference of being present,
sure,
and being there, like,
and that is a huge difference.
That is fucking huge difference.
Like, like being in the room doesn't mean you're there.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a lesson I've learned very hard this year.
And it's trying to find time that, like, time to close things down.
Right.
Like we have it now, like technology. Like people sit in a room on a fucking phone.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone will sit in a room on a fucking phone or whatever. Not
sure.
And just not be present.
Sure.
Like,
I mean,
they're just there.
We
they're
all
occupying
do that.
Space.
We'll catch each other doing that at dinner sometime.
Yeah.
You know, not, you know, anybody. We'll be like, holy shit, I'll look up and we're all on our phone. And be like...
And that's when you just...
Fuck this.
You just take phone down.
Yeah.
Like...
It's hard to do. It's hard to do.
Yeah. That takes...
With tattooing, you can't just put the phone down.
No.
Because it's always there.
Client for the next day.
Well, no, I mean, I'm using the phone as a metaphor.
Yeah.
But tattooing is your phone. You're not going to put it down. It's definitely hard to adjust to. Yeah. But you seem to be working it out these days.
I feel like I am.
I feel like you're turning a lot of trial and error.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I'm not going to get too therapeutic with all this stuff.
No. If people are listening to this and they're having the same fucking issue...
I mean, they must. If they're serious about tattooing...
Exactly.
You either are in it, or you're about to get in it, or you just got out of it. Because it's going to get you.
And I remember, like, a Paradise thing from years ago,
mm-hmm.
where Sean Barber was up at a panel with a bunch of people. I think Damon Conklin was there. Where it's, like, talking about time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like finding someone that's like, you're selfish with time as a tattooer. Like, time is not a thing. It's like, it's a balance. It's like a scale.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you always feel like you're sacrificing something for something else. So.
Right. It's not like going to work, punching the clock, and being done with it.
Exactly. At 5 o'clock.
So to everyone we love out there, we're sorry.
Yeah.
Right?
It happens. Sorry.
So to get on a more, just a different note.
Yeah.
You've been working a lot with Ralf Nonnweiler lately.
Yeah, that's
great. Out of Germany. I know that you talk with him, I don't know, every other day at least.
Yeah.
How did that relationship start?
We shared a booth.
Totally thought you were going to say we shared a bed. I was like, what reason?
he's a handsome guy.
He's fit, that's for sure.
And he doesn't do anything.
I know.
Fuck.
And have you seen his family?
Yeah.
He has like an army of like blue-eyed.
Yeah, they're all Aryans. Yeah, it's like
I don't know how he did it.
But so we shared a booth at
Empire State.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Him and I, and we just kind of hit it off and talked, and then we shared a booth again. He came back here.
And then you went out there, right?
Yep. I just did a guest spot out there.
How was that experience for you?
Awesome.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like, it was one of those moments where you, like, reach a level up and you don't even realize it. You're just, like, around good people and a different environment, and you're working, and the person that's, like, right over there is a fucking badass. Like, there's an expectation.
And he invited you there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. And like,
last time he was on the show, he gave you a lot of compliments too.
Did he?
Yeah.
Nice.
He loves you.
Thank you.
He,
thank you, Ralf. Thank you.
I know you're not watching because it's really late. We're in Germany right now. But I know you will watch this.
Yeah.
So is that something you think you'll do more of? Do you think you'll do more traveling, more guest spots?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to Ralf's in January. And then in February, I'm going to Tony Mancia's.
Sweet.
In Atlanta.
Yep. Can I have your booth?
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
I mean, there's all sorts of cool shit.
I'm just joking. Max does have a lot of shit in his booth.
Yep.
Way less than he used to. I think I've helped pare that down a lot.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It actually looks clean and organized.
Ish.
There's still a shrine. Ish. Like, there's...
It looks all right.
There's a shrine skull.
It's not bad, though.
No.
It's been worse.
Oh, yeah. The collections.
So if anyone's ever been to our shop here in Easthampton, we have a shit ton of bookshelves in the waiting room, and I would say 90% of the stuff on the shelves is Max's.
I showed my mom the other day. She came in, like, after hours. She's like, so that looks like yours, and mm-hmm. that looks like yours. I'm like,
it's actually the safest it's ever been. It's actually kind of nice. It's like, hey, look, Max's museum.
And she's like, you should take that home. I'm like, no, it's actually really safe here. Like,
it's totally fine. Yeah, it's great. Don't touch Max's stuff.
Don't touch my shit.
There's antiques in there.
Yeah. But yeah, it's like, I was like, oh yeah, that's.
So give me a general plan for your year. Give me a 2017 plan. What do you hope to accomplish? You know.
Oh. So 2017 plan.
Mm-hmm. I don't need to know all of it.
Well, no.
He's probably gonna buy some expensive pants, some nice shoes. A good jacket or scarf or two.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, he'll have some romance.
That will, yeah.
But I mean, tattooing-wise.
Tattooing-wise, I'm going to do a few guest spots. Planning on doing quite a bit of traveling. Because I've made all these connections over the years. And it's kind of like, I felt ready to call those people up and be like, hey, mm-hmm. you mind if I come and spend like a week or two?
But I mean, now you can do a guest spot and it's not, I mean, you can do anything that comes through the door. You can bring your own clientele. You can,
yeah.
I wish there's another word for worthy. You're qualified.
Qualified, yeah.
You're qualified to do like nice, high-end guest spots now.
Exactly.
That must feel good.
Yeah, I'm going to Tony's shop in Atlanta. And he's like, yeah, man.
Amazing.
Yeah.
His work is great.
Yeah.
And he's the sweetest dude.
He's super nice.
Mm-hmm.
And he called me up, and he's like, yeah, man.
I have to say, I thought he was a super dick the first time I met him, but it was just because he was really shy.
He is.
And he was and working then just, really hard.
You have to get him on.
I was trying to interrupt him, but at Paradise, he wasn't working.
Is that when we went out and like talked
we were,
outside?
Yeah, yeah, we were just hanging outside. Yeah. He's the sweetest dude ever. I totally gave him the wrong
It took like a couple of meetings to actually like kind of get him on the right like moment.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like, oh, yeah, like you're great.
And when he told me he was afraid to take drugs, I was just like, oh, you are a sweetheart. You're the best.
He married a Swiss woman.
Like, awesome.
So,
are you booked for any of that stuff?
Yeah, they've done a really great job in like contacting me, and he's like, "Yeah, we've been kind of handpicking things."
Wonderful.
Yeah,
I mean, it helps that Tony's got a shop to where they kind of focus on black and gray.
Yep.
So they must field a lot of people. So it's good that they can kind of mesh you in with what's going on over there.
Yeah.
Are you doing any conventions in the coming year?
Maybe.
Maybe? What are you looking at?
Well, I'm going to go to David Corden's in August in Edinburgh.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm away for like a month.
Okay.
So,
a month? Really?
Yeah. Well, I plan on...
What are you doing in the spring? You want to meet me in the Netherlands?
Yeah.
That'll be fun. Yeah. I'll be in Ireland too this year too.
Oh.
I don't remember when.
Fuck yeah. Emerald Isle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm bringing Bob over there.
Nice.
We're going to party.
Fuck yeah.
And then we're going to do India.
Oh, I had a great experience with Bob at Paradise this year. If anyone, like, go to Paradise, like...
Well, we'll see if we ever do it again.
Yeah. It's worth it.
We should come to Goa. India.
Yeah. Larry Brogan's been going to that one, right?
Yeah, I'm going. We're going to rent motorcycles, and we're going to ride all over India. Mm-hmm. Because Martin McIver... who has been doing, he does the Irish tattoo sessions, mm-hmm. also does the Goa convention with another guy. And we're trying to make India a big thing.
Yeah.
It's going to be awesome. You should come.
All right. When?
Mm-hmm. I don't remember. September. No, March. I don't know.
July? My grandmother's turning her 90th birthday.
I don't remember. So another thing. Sorry, Martin, I don't remember right now. I will remember. Fuck. Anyway.
Yeah.
Next year.
Mm-hmm.
Well, thanks, Max.
You're welcome.
It's been good talking to you. If someone wants to get in touch with you about a tattoo, how do they do that? Oh, wait a minute. You're tattooing my dad tomorrow, aren't you? Max is tattooing my dad tomorrow.
Yep.
Don't fuck it up, man.
Hi, Damien.
He's sensitive. He's an actor.
Hence the drama masks?
Mm-hmm. I think he's probably watching right now, too.
Good.
Hi, Dad.
I did a lot of work. I found a craftsman
he messaged me on Facebook. He's like, are you going to be there on Tuesday? I'm like, yeah, I'll be there. He's like, do you think Max is ready? I was like, Max is ready. Don't worry. He's ready.
I actually need to draw some drapery. That's what I'm going to do tonight. So, draw drapery.
Sweet. You can get a hold of Max where?
Maximilian Tattoo.
MaximilianTattoo@gmail.com, or you can go to offthemaptattoo.com and find Max. Or Max has his own really decrepit, aging website because he refuses to update the motherfucker. I think the last time was 2 years ago, and it was probably me that did it for him.
Oh, yeah. Thank
so
you.
So if you Google him, you can find his old shitty website. Or you can go to Off the Map Tattoo and see some of his newer stuff.
Yep. I need to update.
Thanks, Max.
Thanks.
Find someone to do that for you. We'll be back with Josh DeHosa and Kelsey Mull for the news. And Max is leaving before the camera goes off. We'll be back in just a minute.
Sorry.
Tattoo artists are power creators, not power administrators. Save time, money, and trees with Tattoo Release Forms app. Your client will photo his ID, enter personal information, information about the tattoo, health information, initial legal clauses, and sign his name. When the client is finished, you can make session notes and choose inks and needles from the most popular brands and configurations. Preview the form, sign it, and hit upload. The form lands on a secure cloud in seconds as a printable PDF. If you're at a convention or without Wi-Fi, TRF will automatically upload the forms next time you're online. Return clients can simply search for themselves, check to make sure all the information is correct, and sign again. Done in seconds. Download Tattoo Release Forms app from the Apple App Store for free and enjoy 25 free forms. Also available in the UK, Canada, and Australia.
This is Tattoo Now Network News.
Oh, hey.
Oh, hey.
We're live.
Oh.
I am Josh DeHosa, and
yo,
you are?
Kelsey Mull.
Kelsey Mull. How are you doing, Kelsey?
I'm great. How are
you? How's your cell phone?
He's very handsome.
It's Nicolas Cage. Right? Oh, so do you want to talk about the news?
We can talk about the news.
You want to talk about the tattoo news or the crazy news
The
first?
Crazy news.
It's, December 19th, you know what that means?
Happy Oatmeal Muffin Day.
It's Oatmeal Muffin Day. I mean, oatmeal muffins suck.
I don't know that I've actually had an oatmeal muffin.
Exactly, because they suck. There's
oatmeal
so
cookies.
Many other better muffins.
Oatmeal cookies, maybe. Oatmeal muffins.
No, we're not talking about cookies. We're talking about muffins.
Well, I'm
oatmeal
just
muffins
saying.
Are so boring.
Yeah, it's pretty, yeah.
It's like
a bran muffin.
It's like Frasier boring.
I've never actually watched an episode of that show.
Exactly,
but
because
yeah,
it falls into the
sense.
Same category.
Yeah. Okay.
Also, on today's date,
that's pretty cool.
1971 was the anniversary of the release of A Clockwork Orange.
That's pretty cool.
No, it's not cool because that movie sucks. And I'm going to be the first one to go out there and say it because, like, everybody wants to be so cool and love A Clockwork Orange. The movie sucks.
I didn't mind
and
it.
And it's just a bunch of torture bullshit. And it's a bunch of assholes being assholes.
Well, yeah.
And people love it.
They're totally assholes.
So, sorry, Stanley Kubrick. A Clockwork Orange is bullshit. But, The Shining was cool.
Did that come out today? No?
No, it didn't come out today. Uh-huh. But it's another thing that sucked on today's date.
Another thing that sucks.
There's one more thing that sucks on today's date. And then it's Criss Angel's birthday. So we have oatmeal muffins.
And Criss Angel.
We have A Clockwork Orange, and we have Criss Angel.
That's pretty terrible. It's a
and
bad
I don't
day.
Even have anything to say about Criss Angel. Like, I don't even like talking shit on people that I don't know. But
he wears a lot of makeup.
There's nothing wrong with makeup.
No,
but you know what's
I'm
wrong?
Okay with it.
People that aren't magicians trying to be magicians. Like, all that dude ever did was fucking destroy David Copperfield's legacy. Nicolas Cage phone doesn't even like it. Because Criss Angel
he can't even handle
sucks.
It.
So it's three things that suck today. You have the most boring...
Also, Mercury is retrograde.
You have the most boring muffin that's ever mm-hmm. existed. A horrible magician. And just a movie that people think is cool that's not actually cool. And you know what else happened today?
What?
The Electoral College actually chose Donald Trump to be our next president. It's like four farts at one time.
That's more than four. 400 maybe.
It's like farting out a little person that farts on you. It's like not bad enough that you farted on yourself in the shower, but you farted and a person comes out in your shower and
then
fart
farts.
On you.
It's like farting.
It's horrible. It's
just
like a double
going
fart
down.
Shower.
It's like a fractal fart.
It's like farting in a bag.
Yeah. So December 19th sucks.
It's a terrible day.
It's horrible. But you know what's gonna be better? December 20th.
Yes, tomorrow.
Because is every a new day will always get better.
Maybe.
Unless it gets worse.
Yeah.
But let's look forward to tomorrow.
All right.
And let's talk about the real Tattoo Now Network news.
Sounds good.
And not Chris Angel in his horrible, horrible...
He walks on water. He's like Jesus.
He doesn't walk on water. He walks on a fucking wet sidewalk with good cameras. That sucks.
I thought you were bringing Mark up here.
We're going to bring Mark up here right now.
Come.
Because we're going to talk about the Tattoo Now Network news. And the first thing that we're going to talk about is a new collaborative print from Brian Geckel and Guy Aitchison.
Cool.
That you can purchase at hyperspacestudios.com just in time for the holidays. Maybe if Guy is on top of his shit.
If you're a last minute.
He'll get it to you by the day he gets it to you. But Mark was on the show earlier, and it's awesome because I work next to Mark every day.
Me too,
and
most days.
Sometimes you work across the room. Yeah. Don't try to fucking jump
sometimes
in.
Sometimes we're on the
Don't
diagonal.
Don't jump in on my glory right here. Ooh. I work next to him every day.
Whoa.
And it's great because I love that dude. And speaking of Guy,
yes.
Let's show off Mark's
Come
chest.
Come show your tatty blaster.
We're going to bring
Sorry,
Mark up here.
I just said that.
Because we want to show
yes.
off Mark's.
I was wondering if they were going to ever come up here.
I don't know. Somewhere right, in on the
here.
Screen.
This works.
Okay.
Oh, just right there.
Oh, ow! Why are you zooming in on my face?
Whoa.
How far?
Move over towards Kelsey.
Perfect. Meet her right there.
So, that's super red.
Yeah, it was super red.
This is really uncomfortable.
There you go.
This is really uncomfortable.
Sorry, it's all good.
So, yeah, if you want, you can go to hyperspace and get prints from that chest.
Oh, yeah?
Prints?
Yes,
no.
Prints.
Like he's not doing prints of my chest.
Prints of the dude that made your chest.
Yes, prints by the dude that made my chest.
And a collaboration with Brian Gissel.
It's pretty damn awesome,
My abs hurt.
Okay. It's kind of awkward.
Yeah.
Thanks, Mark.
Thanks, Mark.
Yeah, no problem. Whoa.
I like how he took his shirt off and then put the hoodie back over so he could...
So, that was cool.
That was cool.
We just had a chest between us. First time, yeah, boom, it's an explosion. All right.
Had some man nipples on Mac Live.
So, anyway, let's move on.
What's next?
May 12th, which sounds like a cool day that some cool shit could happen. Grants Pass, off the map tattoo. Decorotif, is that how you say that?
Sounds right.
That sound right? Yeah, it's gonna happen. Small event that's gonna bring some awesome decorative and ornamental tattooers together.
I think a lot of the Ink and Dagger crew is gonna be
and
there.
And Grants Pass Organ. I know Russ will be there. And Jeff will be there. Jeff will be there because he works there.
He does. He's there all the time.
Laura, Colleen.
Savannah Colleen.
Savannah Colleen. And. It's going to be a lot of off the dagger. Is that what you want to call it?
Inking dagger?
Should we call it
Inking dagger?
Ink the map, off the dagger
the
event?
Map. Yeah, that's
cool. It's going to be rad. So you can go to tattoonow.com, purchase tickets for a pretty awesome event. I kind of want to maybe check it out. What are you thinking?
May 12th.
May 12th.
That's way too far in advance for me to like even
May
comprehend.
May the 12th be with you.
Almost.
Don't forget that the intros are going to be
Mm. Oh.
They're going to be what? Oh, so we got a...
Special.
Oh, special.
So also...
My hockey helmet special?
Got one more little thing. I was going to talk about, tattoo news in general, in the world off of the Tattoo Now Network. But the only thing I could find was about celebrities getting tattoos, and I didn't give a shit about it, so we're not going to talk about it. I don't care what celebrity got what tattoo. But we're going to throw in one last thing. If you're looking for some last-minute holiday gifts... go make them, because that's really cool. But if you don't want to make them, you can have someone else make them.
What the fuck, just make them.
You can have someone else make them with a tattoo gift certificate.
Oh,
that was good, right?
No.
Oh, but what if that tattoo gift certificate's from Phil Robertson?
Well, we get a sweet bio.
Yeah. So he has a gift certificate sale going on. You can spend $120 or. You can spend $100 and get an additional $25 and an extra special gift.
Ooh.
Yeah, you like that? Check out PhilRobertsonTattoos.com. And that is, that's all we got.
That's it.
But we're going to throw the mics back to Ben. He's going to say goodbye. And we're going to leave you with some music from quite possibly the best band that's ever existed.
The Dry Wipes.
Yeah. Yeah.
This makes you think of butts.
Well, of course.
Even in what? The fashion world.
But you know what? Like, butts are cool.
I love butts.
Who doesn't like butts?
Wiping butts?
Butthole?
I mean, I would rather wipe a butt than have an unwiped butt in my life.
That's
true.
Gross.
Yeah.
So, like, the best thing about butts is a wiped butt.
But with a wet wipe, not a dry wipe.
Well, you know what? We're going to just throw the mics back to Ben, and then we're going to leave you with the dry wipes.
So, I'm Dax McClellan. I'm the creator of TattooingPortraits.com, and I'm the author of The Savage Way. Really, though, I just want to help tattoo artists overcome and learn how to do black and gray realism in portraits. I'm hosting a live 1 hour webinar, but it's this Wednesday, okay? And it's only for the first 100 people that register below. All you gotta do is click the link, fill it out, and I'll see you this Wednesday. If you wanna learn how to tattoo black and gray portraits without ruining your client's skin. I've been there. I had to learn how to do portraits on my own. I didn't have an apprenticeship. I've screwed up clients. I've screwed up my own confidence, and I know how not to do that. I know what works. I know the systems. And in this webinar, I'm going to go through all the things I know. I'm going to share my personal step-by-step portrait system. I'm going to share how to improve the shades and transitions between your tones and how to understand gray wash. Also, how to shade smoother. I'm going to throw all that in there. And I'm going to do a live Q&A at the end of the webinar. But it's only for the first 100 people to sign up and show up live. This Wednesday, okay? Fill it out right now. I'm gonna give you the opportunity to get my book at a discounted rate. You get a discount, and I'm gonna throw in $97 worth of bonuses when you enter right now. Now, this is only for the first 100 people. It might not be available tomorrow. Register for a webinar, get the book. I'll see you this Wednesday.
So, Josh Sahoza's website, imnotalltheremyself.com, instead of something smart like joshsahoza.com. You can catch them there. And Kelsey, what's yours?
I believe it's just
Unicorn Glitter Blaster. UnicornGlitterBlaster.com instead of something smart like KelseyMull.com. Go find their work. Or you can just go to Off the Map. It's way easier to find them. Say what? Peanut Gallery?
No, I said I should look for something smart like JoshSahoza.com.
Yeah, right. That's better.
Thing.
Yeah, that's way better.
You're never going to get it.
Hi, my website is 3sentences.com.
That might be available too.
Probably is. Anyway, it's the last show of the season. Thank you guys all for watching. The next show is going to be a best of. I've had fun. I hope you've had fun. Thank you for watching, all whatever million of you. Dozen of you. Anyway, I'm Ben Licata. We are Off the Map Live. I hope your 2016 was okay. I know Donald Trump was a big disappointment. I'm not really psyched about it either. Hopefully 2017 will be a little better. At least we can laugh at that orange fucker. Later.